Hey friends, hi to all and welcome back to Food for Toddlers. Today I am bringing a colorful recipe. Colors always add appeal to the food, but colors used here are all natural. Friends, these colors are made from vegetable puree. So addition of these colors or vegetable puree brings in some more additional nutrition to this sweet. It's again a fusion sweet. It's made of dry coconut and white chocolate. You can even call them bounty bar laddus. So friends, let's head on to the requirements. We need dry or desiccated coconut, milk, sugar for sweetness, white chocolate. For puree making or to add color, I'm using spinach, carrot and beetroot. Let's start making this wonderful sweet. We'll begin with adding some milk to the pan. I'm using here around 300 ml of milk. When milk is hot enough, add the measured quantity of sugar to it. And then just mix all the sugar and milk together so that it starts dissolving in the milk. Keep stirring until the sugar is completely dissolved. Once you get a uniform liquid, add the desiccated or dry coconut to it. Give a stir so that it blends along with the milk. Then add the remaining amount of dry coconut to it. Again give a stir so that it uniformly blends. Stirring is an important step of this sweet making. You have to keep stirring until the coconut completely absorbs the milk. But it hardly takes 5 minutes, not more than that. As you can see here, the quantity of milk is slowly getting reduced. Friends, you have to keep stirring until you get a completely dry texture and the milk is completely absorbed. So friends, as you can see, slowly we are reaching to the required texture. Milk has been completely reduced and this is the required texture to bind it into balls. Now let's transfer this mixture into a bowl and let's start making small balls of it. Friends, I'm making balls out of it. You can go for any shape you like. So friends, I've just made round balls out of it and it's all set to go inside the refrigerator. It's always better to refrigerate these balls to retain their shape and texture. This is all set after refrigeration. Friends, refrigeration helps in retaining the shape as we'll be dipping these balls into hot chocolate. Now let's start preparing the chocolate to coat the balls. To melt the white chocolate, I've added few pieces on a water bath. Actually friends, I'll suggest to choose white chocolate over the brown one as it helps in adding the wonderful color to the sweet. Friends, keep stirring as the chocolate melts or else it may stick to the bottom and may get overcooked. Just stop the flame once you get the flowing consistency, something like this. And to maintain the texture of chocolate, keep it placed on the water bath. Let's leave the chocolate on the water bath. And meanwhile, we'll do the other preparations. Let's start preparation of the plate by greasing some oil on it. By doing so, actually we avoid sticking of the chocolate balls to the plate and it's easy to take it out. Make sure you cover the plate completely with oil. Now let's throw the balls in the chocolate and coat them well. With the help of fork or spoon, just coat the chocolate uniformly over the balls. Once the coconut balls are completely coated with chocolate, just place back it on the plate. And before the chocolate hardens, let's dress it up. I'm using some colored candied fruits here. It can be even dressed up with choco chips. Now let's start preparing the puree. First I'm making spinach puree. For that, to a steamer I'm adding fresh baby spinach leaves. I normally prefer cooking this leaf by just steaming as it helps in retaining the maximum nutritive value. I've used here almost a bunch of spinach, goes in the steamer and now I'm covering it with a lid and I'll be steaming it for around 2 minutes. When the spinach reduces in size, it is the signal that it is completely cooked. Now to enhance the green color, we'll be pouring chilled water over the hot spinach. Once the spinach is at room temperature, now it's time to blend it. Now we'll be taking 2 to 3 tablespoons of white chocolate and mixing it with spinach puree to give a green color. Ratio can be completely decided by you, just taste the combination. Chocolate should have the dominant flavor over the spinach. Now I'm covering the coconut ball completely with this puree and chocolate combination. And once it's completely coated, we'll keep it on the plate. Now I'll be steaming the carrot and beetroot pieces. Actually friends, this step is optional, but I'll suggest going for it because steaming enhances the nutritive value of these wonderful vegetables. To make these vegetables tender, I have steamed them around 4 to 5 minutes. To check whether the vegetables are properly cooked, I'll be inserting fork into them. They are soft enough to be blended. Let's blend both the vegetables separately to get pink and orange color. For both the purees, we'll be repeating the same step. I've taken here 2 to 3 tablespoons of white chocolate and I'm blending it along with the puree. After uniformly coating these coconut balls, keep it on the greased plate. For getting a softer texture, you can leave it on room temperature. And friends, by keeping it under refrigeration, you get a harder texture. And friends, my personal favorite of the sweet is the puree version. As vegetable puree not only adds color and nutrition to the sweet, it also adds good amount of moisture to the chocolate coating, which actually helps out in bringing the tender texture of the sweet. That just melts in the mouth, so do give it a try. And I'm sure your kids are gonna love this version of vegetables. So friends, this is Siji from Food for Toddlers signing off for today. Let's catch up again in the next video. Until we meet again, do take care of yourself, eat well.